Speaking of lacing up the skates, four more guys added to the All-Star game coming up in a couple of weeks out in San Jose. The last men in voting complete ended at 11:59 last night. These are the last four guys. Got Leon Draisaitl representing the Oilers. Gabe Landeskog, captain of the Colorado Avalanche. How about Jeff Skinner? We're going to talk a whole lot about him tonight and his return to Carolina, getting the nod for the Atlantic Division. And last but certainly not least, Kris Letang, defenseman, having a standout year on the blue line in Pittsburgh. Scotty, I'll start with you. And we went through this yesterday. Did the fans get it right with their last-second votes here last night?
Yeah, they did pretty good. They did pretty good. Yeah.
Okay.
I mean,
You like the defense, but you like Letang, I know that.
Oh, yeah, I like Letang. I think them all. They all deserve to be there, for
all
sure.
All deserving. That's the hard part.
And Letang, I really think he's having a bounce-back year. Not like he had a terrible year last year, but I thought it was like a 50-point year. I thought he was chasing the game. Defensively, he wasn't as good. Right now, I think he's got the whole game going, which I like in a defenseman. He's a complete package, defends well, moves the puck up the ice, quarterback of the power play. And we talked about how valuable he is to getting the puck up to the good forwards, the Kessels, the Crosbys, the Malkins, and that's what he does very well. And he's got a little bit of bite to his game. He's a little physical, I'm sure. Hartz, you guys played against the Pittsburgh Penguins, and you know that. But for a smaller guy, I always thought, man, this guy should stay out of it. But he likes to get his nose in there. He plays with a fair bit of moxie.
Yeah, you know, I think when you get under his skin, he's a guy that elevates his game and you know, comes right back at you. And he can lead the rush. He's a great first pass defenseman getting out of their zone, like you said. And he's got that big shot, too. And he's got some silky mitts, too. You know, a couple big goals in the playoffs. He's down low behind the net, you know, toe dragon. So when you have that as a defenseman, it's almost like an extra forward out there. So great picks.
They also use him in the shootout. Shows how good, like you said, his slicky hands. They will use him in a shootout. Yeah. You don't see too many D going in shootouts.
All right,
I was never going.
I don't know. I wouldn't argue against you if you wanted to go, that's for sure. So he has the silky mitts. You talk about a guy like Jeff Skinner. We talk about the silky skates. Just one of those impressive skaters in the National Hockey League. We always hear 10-2. What impresses you the most about the way this guy uses his blades?
He's so good on his edges, and you think you might have him, you know, pinned in a corner or whatever. You know, he does that tight turn, and he's out of it with his first two strides. So we're going to look at a couple clips here of Mr. Skinner himself, but this is a pretty cool one here. We talked about it before, 10-2. He does a little push, another push, and he's way by Lovejoy. And what I like about the ending, too, is that shot. He's got about a six-inch little hole to put that puck in and does just that. But the way that he gets power off that back leg, there he goes again. 10-2, the puck is inside the zone. Push, another little push, another, you know, maybe a soft goal by Luongo, but it's just real neat how he gets that that extra little speed. You see Crosby do it a lot. It might be something that these kids are learning that I didn't learn that when I was learning how to skate. Yeah, on this one, just a nice little, I think he's waiting for that puck to come. He's protecting it. Nice move, you know, to lift it up and get elevation on this one as well. So this one I kind of like the most. The guy that goes into traffic to stick handle, he's getting checked. He's got stick between his leg. He's falling down and still roofs it. Pretty neat little package here. The Skinner's having a heck of a year from coming from Carolina. And this is going to be a big night for him going back to Carolina. Just a lot of emotions probably going through him, through his mind right now.
That skating foundation, especially with Skinner, you always hear about how he got his start, the figure skating, and it kind of led into hockey, and that's why sometimes we see those moves that he's doing. How, and I'll ask you, because you played recently, how many guys are kind of working with figure skaters or skating coaches like that to work on their edges, because we see how effective it can be in games?
Well, I think nowadays it's, I wouldn't say it's mandatory to have the figure skating part of it, but the power skating, the Power Edge Pro in Toronto that McDavid uses, all, Tavares, you know, all these guys that are doing that, they're not just doing it in August or middle of August when they start skating. They take a couple weeks off and they're doing it in May, June, July. So they never really take time off skating, which, you know, you gain power, you gain confidence in doing those moves. And, you know, when you're, it's one thing when you're doing it half speed, but, you know, when they're going full speed like they are during a game and they can do these moves and tight turns and control the puck, it's something that I really didn't have in my game. You know, wish I did at times, but it's so fun to watch these guys move. And, you know, it's not just Skinner, it's, you know, almost the whole league that can do it.
Yeah.
I noticed in some of those videos, there's a great video, when he does that 10-2, at times it's like he gets a little skinnier, and actually it's easier to protect the puck, if you think about it. Instead of being square on, it's easier for the guy to poke it. When he does that 10-2, he can get himself a little farther away from the defender, harder to get the poke check, and then he pushes around him. But it almost looks like a bit of a crab out there, the way he's moving. But Jason Zucker does it very well, who I coached in Minnesota, and he's phenomenal at it. And it's almost like they accelerate out of it, Hartsey, which is amazing, that they can actually gain more speed coming out of that.
And that's the power of these legs, right?
Yeah, it's pretty cool. But not a lot of guys can do it. In our day and age, Ulf Dahlin was a guy that did it a lot. He's a Swedish guy. He might have been a little before you, but he was very good at that 10-2, a Swedish guy. And we were all like, what is this guy doing? Like, this is odd. But now it's kind of like it's part of instructional teaching, and these guys are learning this, and it's effective.